Good morning, students. As we have discussed in previous lecture, topic parabola. Now today we will discuss chapter conic section, topic ellipse. Now topic ellipse we will discuss today. What are the geometrical conditions when cone and a plane intersect each other? Under the condition when, let's see, this we have to plot rough idea. As you know, when, suppose this is cone which is generated, napped cone, and this angle axis and generator makes an angle alpha. As I have told you, angle beta is also there. Suppose this upper part of the nap cone, suppose this is, let's see, it is alpha, and the plane which is intersecting to the cone, this angle is beta. Now relation between alpha and beta gives you shape of or section of a cone. Relation of alpha and beta gives you sections of cone. In parabola, alpha angle is equal to beta angle. In the case of parabola, which we have discussed in previous lecture, if this beta is greater than alpha but less than 90 degree, if beta is greater than alpha and less than 90 degree, in this case, in this condition, section will be ellipse. Ellipse is one type of curve. As in science we have studied, planets move in a elliptical shape. So same shape is here. It is drawn. Two foci are there in this figure. First focus F1, second focus is F2. And P1, P2, P3 are supposed points lying on a elliptical path. Now, how to recognize this is an ellipse? How to recognize? Here is a condition to recognize the ellipse. As in the case of parabola, we recognize it when the distance from the fixed point and distance from the fixed line are same. Then the curve gives you shape that is parabolic shape. Now, in the case of ellipse, when distance from P1 point to F and distance of P1 from F2, sum of these two distances, P1 F1, P1 F2, these two distances equal to constant. Same if I take P2 F1, P2 F2, sum of these two distances always constant, as it is written here. Distance of a point from the first focus and the second focus, calculate these distances and add them. Sum of the distances is always constant. This gives you an idea. This is a curve which is known as the ellipse curve, elliptical curve. Now, what are the equations of ellipse and what are other points, other conditions which you must know about the ellipse? Let's see. First thing which you know, the axis, greater axis, that is from A to B, is known as major axis, and axis from C to D is known as minor axis, and O is the center of the ellipse, and the distance from O to F2 and O to F1, these are same distances and these are known as C distance, as it is written here, distance C. So focus F1 and F2 have coordinates c comma 0 and minus c comma 0 in this shape specially. And the distance from C to D, from C to D it is B plus B, it is 2B. And from A to B it is 0 to O to A is A and O to B is A, it is 2A. From A to B, distance is 2A. From C to D, it is distance 2B. And the coordinates of focus are plus minus A comma 0. And O is the center of the ellipse that is having coordinates 0, 0. So here are points which you have to remember: major axis, minor axis, foci F1 and F2, center O, and vertex A and V. Vertex A and B. A and B are known as vertex of the ellipse. Now here we have studied about the ellipse, which is the horizontal ellipse. If this ellipse is having shape like this, then it becomes a vertical ellipse. Now in this case, we will study this also. Horizontal and vertical, both ellipse we will study in the exercise. Now here is the relationship between major axis, semi-minor axis, and distance of the focus from the center of the ellipse. It means relation between semi-major axis. It means major axis is A, A plus A, major axis length is 2A, minor axis length is 2B. It means when I'm talking about semi, it means we are talking about A and B. And the distance of the focus from the center, it means we are talking about C. It means relation between A, B and C. It is a relation which we have to learn. A square is equal to B square plus C square, or you can say C is equal to under the root A square minus B square. Learn this, because when you want to find out the focus having coordinate C comma 0 plus minus C comma 0, then you have to use this formula, that is C is equal to under the root A square minus B square. Now few special cases are here. Let's see what are the special cases. In the special cases, in the equation C square is equal to A square minus B square, which we have studied above, if we keep A fixed and vary C from 0 to A, the resulting ellipse will vary in the shapes. It means what? First case is, if C is 0, C becomes 0. Both foci merge together with the center of the ellipse, and A square is equal to B square. A and B both are equal. It means ellipse become a circle when C is equal to 0. If C is equal to A and B is equal to 0, B becomes 0. It means this point joins with this point, and C becomes A. It means this compressed and becomes a line segment, that is F1, F2 line segment. These are the conditions. Now next is eccentricity. It's a new word which we have not studied in till now. Eccentricity is the ratio of C and A. C is the distance of center to foci, and A is the semi-major axis distance. So E is equal to, eccentricity is equal to C upon A. This you have to learn, because this is one of the questions which you have to find out when question is asked, find out eccentricity, then the formula is used here. Standard equations of an ellipse. Now to find out the equation, what we have studied, P is a point which is lying on the ellipse, and distance from P1 to F1 at distance P F2, that is always equal to constant, take that is equal to 2a suppose. Now apply this condition and you will get an algebraic equation, that is x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1 for the horizontal ellipse. For the vertical ellipse, the equation will be x square upon b square y square upon a square is equal to 1. You can observe when the x-axis is the major axis, then you are getting x square upon a square. When x-axis is the minor axis, then you are getting x square upon b square. And a square is always greater than b square. Major axis gives you a square and minor axis about b. If foci are on x-axis, you are taking c comma 0 and minus c comma 0. If you are taking foci on the y-axis, it means 0 comma c and 0 comma minus c. Here the coordinates are a comma 0, vertex are minus a comma 0, here 0 a and 0 minus because it is on y-axis, and the b comma 0 and minus b comma 0. These are the coordinates. You must observe these conditions. Now further is, this is a condition applied, sum of the distances equal to 2a, and when you simplify it, you are getting the equations. Yes, here is the equation. Now, ellipse is the curve which is symmetrical about x-axis as well as symmetrical about y-axis, which you have to learn. Now, questions. Now, latest rectum you have to know. मिशु कपड़े उठा और वीडियो चलने लगी, कपड़े उठा बड़ा बड़े दादी, कपड़े भीग गए सारे ऐसा। आंटी आ गई मालिश वाली, मेरे को थोड़ा टोकना पड़ा बीच में, आधा भीड़ करते करते। Now, latus rectum is, as I have told you, latus rectum is a chord which is passes through the foci and perpendicular to axis. This length AB and CD are known as the latus rectum. And what is the length of latus rectum? It is always equal to, that is, length of latus rectum is 2B square upon A. Learn this formula. What is the length of latus rectum? 2b square upon a. This is the length of latus rectum. Now do examples. Now examples are, let's see example number 1. That is example number 9. As find the coordinates of the foci and the vertices, the length of major axis, minor axis, centricity, latus rectum, foci, vertices, length of major axis, minor axis, eccentricity, and latus rectum. If you know all these formulae, then you can find the values of all these terms. Now, equation is x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. When the term which is under the x greater than the term which is under the y square. Then it means what? This is a ellipse, horizontal ellipse like this. If question is x square upon 9 plus y square upon 25 is equal to 1. Now 25 is under the y square, then ellipse will be like this, vertical ellipse. Then you have to observe this, which one is greater than. It depends on the given statement and draw the shape accordingly. Okay. Now here is, now always you know that the term which is greater is equal to 25. A square is equal to 25, B square is equal to 9. If A is 25, then A is equal to plus minus 5, B is equal to plus minus 3. It means the value of A is this one, B is this one. As you know, C is equal to under the root A square minus B square. As I have told you formula, that is 25 minus 9, C is equal to under root 16 and it is equal to 4. C is 4, A is plus minus 25, B is plus minus 3. As you know, all three values, these are the values which will give you all the answers. Foci means plus minus C comma 0. Plus minus C comma 0 means plus minus 5 comma 0. Vertex. Vertex means A comma 0 and minus A comma, sorry, foci C value is 4, not 5. Plus minus 4 comma 0. The value of C I have taken 5, that is 4. 4 comma 0. Now it is vertex we are talking about. Minus A comma 0, it means this is 5 comma 0 or minus 5 comma 0, or you can say plus minus 5 comma 0. Now next one is length of measure axis. Length of measure axis is, length of measure axis 2A, it means 2 into A. A is 5, it is 10. Minor axis length will be equal to 2B. That is 2 into B is 3, that is 6. Now length of latest rectum, eccentricity first. Eccentricity is C upon A. What is C? 4. A is 5. 4 upon 5. Now what is length of latest rectum? That is B, 2B square upon A. 2 into B square is 9. Upon A means 5. 18 upon 5. This is the length of latest rectum. As what are the requirements? If you got A, B and C, then you can find any of the term which is required. I think you have to learn the formulae. Let's see now answer of the question number, this one, example 9. Let's see, yes, it is C is 4. Coordinates of foci, plus minus 4, 0, plus minus 5, 0, vertices. 18 upon 5 is the length of latex rectum. Eccentricity is 4 upon 5. All these are the answer which we have discussed. Okay. Now, example number 10. Whenever question is given to you, you have to check whether it is given in a standard form or not in a standard form. Question is 9x square plus 4y square is equal to 36. But standard form is what? X square upon A square plus Y square upon B square is equal to 1, or X square upon B square plus Y square upon A square is equal to 1. Constant term will always be 1. How to make it 1? Divide this whole statement by 36. What you are getting? 9x square upon 36 plus 4y square upon 36 is equal to 1. When you simplify it, you will get this one. Now, y square upon 9. 9 is more than 4. It means this is an ellipse which is vertical ellipse. Now foci will be 0 comma plus minus c. Now you have to remember it. From this equation, you have to find out what type of ellipse you are getting. Now a square is greater one is known as a square. And b square is 4. Then A and B are A is plus minus 3, B is plus minus 2. Now find out C. So you want what? Vertex, major axis, minor axis, eccentricity. Apply, you have to apply formula when you will get the value of C. That is a square minus b square. Now you are getting 9 minus 4, that is root 5. It means the value of C is root 5. Yes, we got root 5 here. This is root 5. Eccentricity formula, C upon A, apply it. And foci is there, vertex is there, you know, this is a vertical ellipse, so 0 comma plus minus C. This is plus minus C, okay? Vertex is 0 comma plus minus A. And ellipse, eccentricity is equal to C upon A, or you can say root 5 upon, that is 3. Now you can find question number 11. Find the equation of ellipse whose vertices are plus minus 13 comma 0 and foci are plus minus 5 comma 0. Let's see, vertices are given to you. Vertices means plus minus a comma 0 and foci means plus minus c comma 0. So the values of it is plus minus, that is vertex given to you. Let's see, vertex is vertices are plus minus 13 comma 0 and foci is plus minus 5 comma 0. As I have told you, foci means the vertices of foci are plus minus c comma 0. So value of c will be equal to plus minus 5 and it is equal to plus minus a comma 0. It means a is equal to 13. If a is 13, c is 5 plus minus 5. The value c square is equal to a square minus b square. Put the values of a and c. What you will get? B. B will be equal to 12. B is equal to 12. Now equation of ellipse, because foci is, which one ellipse makes? That is a horizontal ellipse. It means x square upon a square plus y square upon b square equal to 1. What is a square? A square is 13 square. It means x square upon 169 plus y square upon b square means b is what? 12. 144 equal to 1. This is the equation of ellipse, which is a required equation. Now come to the example number 12. Find the equation of ellipse whose length of major axis. Length of major axis means 2a is given 20. And foci means 0 comma plus minus c, because on y-axis ellipse will be vertical ellipse. Okay. So the value of c you can get from here. C is equal to plus minus 5. A you can get from here. A is equal to 10. If a and c are here, then you can apply this formula to get the value of b square. So what is the value of b square? Now you can put the values of c square, a square, you will get b square is equal to 75. Now equation of ellipse will be what? Equation is a vertical ellipse. A vertical ellipse means x square upon b square plus y square upon a square is equal to 1. It means x square upon, that is b square is 75. Y square upon a square. A square means 10 square, that is 100. This is the answer. Now come to the example number 13. Example number 13. Now find the equation of ellipse whose major axis along the x-axis. Okay, it means ellipse is x square upon a square plus y square upon b square. And these are the two points which are lying on that ellipse like this. Suppose these are the point 4, 3 in the first quadrant, First is negative, second is positive. It means it's lying here, minus 1, 4. These are the two points which are lying on ellipse. It means these two points will satisfy the equation of the ellipse. It means put x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 3 in first case. In second case, x is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to 4. You are getting these two equations. Now simplify these two equations. I hope you can do the equations. Simplify the equations. You can do the question direct. Let's see. Suppose when I multiply this by 1 and this by 16, you are getting 16 upon a square plus 9 upon b square is equal to 1. 16 upon a square plus 16 into 16 square is upon b square is equal to 1. Now subtract these two equations. When you subtract, sign is changing. So here is 16, sorry. So these are two cancelled terms. 1 upon b square take common. You are getting 9 minus 16 square. That is minus 15. What you will get? You will get, when you simplify it, you are getting b square is equal to 247 upon 15. B square is equal to 247 upon 15. Put this b square in any of the equations. 1 upon a square plus 16 upon b square is equal to 1. When you put b square, 1 upon a square plus 16 into 15 upon 247 is equal to 1. When you simplify it, you are getting b square is equal to 247 upon 7. You are getting both a square and b square. Now, what is the equation of the ellipse? That will be x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. Put the value of a square, you are getting 7 x square upon 247 and 15 y square upon 247 equal to 1, or you can say 7 x square plus 15 y square is equal to 247. This is the answer of the example number 13. Let's see. Yes, this is the 7x square plus 15y square is equal to 247. This is example number last 15. Now do the exercise 11.3. I hope you can do, because all the questions of, especially in this chapter, all the questions are related to examples in this exercise. So do the exercises by first doing examples, then start to do exercise, and you can able to do all the questions of exercise. Hope you will do. Thank you. Have a nice day.